Hi everyone, this is Manas, your friend and tutor. Another brilliant day, another brilliant problem. And we are going to be continuing with our session on deflection of beams. And today, we are going to take a look at this problem. This is rather based on a simply supported beam. And as you can see, there are two point loads at a distance of 3 and at a distance of 6.5 from the leftmost end of the beam. Hame kya karna hai isme? What we need to really work out is the deflection at this point. The deflection at this point also, that is at C and D, and we also need to work out the maximum deflection. So one thing is for sure that the maximum deflection is going to happen between C and D. That's quite obvious. But again, for calculating the magnitudes of those deflections, we need an equation. Now, our objective right now is to frame an equation, and what we need to do is we need to do a section. Start karte hain. One by one. Let's begin by sectioning. So let me start from here. I don't know. Pura board bharne wala hai abhi. This much space won't be enough. Let's see. Section from the left. So obviously, if you have been watching my lectures, I already always select the origin at the leftmost end of the beam. Right? Very orthodox. From left to the right, you keep on increasing the value of x. I mean, that is what I follow. You can follow anything. You can take the section from the rightmost end, that is end B also. Anyway, section from left. Let's start. Alright, these data have already been given to you. Let me make a separation line. So when you take the section from the left, when you do that, what happens? Let me just show you. We need to write the moment equation first. The section has to be taken in such a manner that all the external loads are 90, 60, all of them will be covered. Anyway, before taking the section, there is a little work which we need to do, and that is calculation of the reactions. So let's say this is RA and let's say this is RB. So the first thing which you immediately need to do is this. Let me just show that to you. RA plus RB, both of them are upwards, and these two forces are downwards. 90 plus 60 is 150. Done. That's one equation. We need the values of RA and RB. Now moment, let's say we are doing this, moment about A is equal to 0. So obviously you have this force multiplied by distance, 90 multiplied by 3 clockwise. So minus of 90 multiplied by 3. Then you have this 60 multiplied by 3 plus 6.5. Obviously this is clockwise minus 60 multiplied by 9.5, isn't it? 60 multiplied by 9.5. And what else we have? We've got this RB. This is anti-clockwise, sort of anti-clockwise. So 4.5 plus 6.5 will give you 11. 11 plus 3 is 14. So this is obviously going to be 14 times of RB is equal to 0. And guys, on solving this equation, you are going to get the value of RB. What is RB going to be? Well, RB is going to work out as 60 kilonewtons. Just try to solve this equation. And let me quickly make a check. Sab cheeze sahi ho rahi hai ki nahi? RB will obviously work out as 60 kilonewtons. Remember, we are working with this unit, kilonewtons, and not newtons. So later on, some kind of conversion has to be carried out. Batayenge sari cheeze. Now, one thing we know, that RB is equal to 60. You just put this value 60 over here. Shift it towards the right. 150 minus 60 will give you obviously 90. Okay. So the value of RB is 60. Let me just write this. RB works out as 60 kilonewton, and RA eventually work out as 90 kilonewton. Right? Let's proceed now. Let me rub this. I think this is baby mechanics, and if you're a civil or a mechanical engineer, you should know this stuff. Okay? Very, very fundamental stuff. So we know both the reactions. Let us do a section. Section from the left, and we've picked this A as the origin. We picked A as the origin. When we do the section, let's see, you are right here. Right here. Okay, let me just extend this slightly. Okay. This much portion of the beam is what we are going to consider. That's the portion. There you go. So what are the forces acting? Just got to be patient. Just take a look at this. This is one force. Then we've got this. okay, and then you've got an end support. How much the value is 90 kilonewtons. Abhi sara kaam jo hai na 90 matlab kilonewtons mein chal raha hai, to ab dhyan rakhiyega at the end we need to do the conversion from kilonewtons to newtons. Okay, so let me just plug in the values. Here we go. This is 90 kN, and this entire length, the section has been taken, this length is entirely x, this entire length, okay? So this is going to be 90, this is 60, and this, since you have taken the section from the left hand side, obviously this is going to be anti-clockwise. Let's say this is mx. Brilliant. Now एक बार मैं आपको यहीं पे मोमेंट कैलकुलेट करके दिखाता हूँ, एंड देन विल राइट द फाइनल वैल्यू ओवर हियर, राइट? एनीवे, जस्ट टेक अ लुक एट दिस. दिस इज गोना बी सुपर ऑसम. व्हाट यू डू नीड टू डू इज यू नीड टू टेक द मोमेंट अबाउट एनी पॉइंट. लेट्स सी, वी आर पिकिंग दिस पॉइंट इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो ऑब्वियसली लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर. दिस इज एंटी क्लॉक वाइज, पॉजिटिव. लेट्स स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर देन अबाउट दिस पॉइंट, क्लॉक वाइज मल्टीप्लाइड बाई एक्स. सो -90 टाइम्स ऑफ एक्स, डन. 90, this over here, anti-clockwise. So plus 90 multiplied by this distance from here to here. This distance I'm talking about, only this much. So this much is x, this is 3. So this is going to be x minus 3. Then we've got this 60. This is also anti-clockwise in nature. So positive 60. And what we have over here is this distance. Perpendicular distance, isn't it? How much is this? That's x, and that's 9.5. So this is going to be x minus 9.5, and that is equal to 0. So this is going to be our moment equation. You just need to shift all of these values over to the right hand side, and you have, what you have is the moment equation. So when you do this section, you've got this. Let me just write this. Mx is equal to, here we go, 90x positive, 90x done, minus 90 times of x minus 3. Okay, and plus 60 times of, I need to make these separation lines also, na? Okay, so better to make the separation line. Let's start from here, 90x. Okay, if you have the section between A and C, then obviously this force will be considered, 90x only. Separation line A, C. After that, what we have is 90 into x minus 3. This 90 into x minus 3. Again, this is going to be minus, you see, shifted, minus times of 90 x minus 3, right? Again a separation line. Now we are between regions C and D, and you've got this 60 times of x minus 9.5. so obviously a negative sign again, 60 times of x minus 9.5. so that's our moment equation, which we need to integrate once to get the slope equation, which we need to integrate again to get the equation of deflection. कैसे करनी ये सारी चीज़ें मैं बताता हूँ. Okay, now there is one more way of perceiving all these things, one more way of calculating the moment at a section. ये भी दिखाता हूँ मैं आपको, ये देखिए. Let me just tell you, let's say this distance is x, and you need to find the moment at this section, and obviously the loads acting are, this is 90, then there is this 90, then there is this 60, this distance is this is 3 meters, this is 6.5 meters. Yeah, there you go, that's 3, that's 6.5. now let's say you want the moment about this section, x, right? Simply you want the moment about this section. How do you do that? So you need to follow the hogging sagging approach. If the force tends to bend the beam in this direction, let's take it as positive, take the moment as positive. If the force tends to bend the beam in this direction, take it as negative. If you watch carefully, this 90, with respect to this particular point, this 90 is in the upper direction. Obviously, it is going to bend the beam into some kind of this form, right? This form, that's sagging for you. Obviously, this is going to be 90 into x. If you watch carefully, this force over here, 90 force, will bend the beam in this direction. So this is a case of hogging. Therefore, you need to take a negative sign. That is going to be 90 multiplied by this distance is how much? X minus 3. Then you've got this force. Now, this is also going to bend the beam into this fashion, isn't it? This fashion. This is also a case of hogging. Obviously, you're going to take a negative sign, minus 60 times of x minus 3 plus 6.5. Kitna hoga ye? 9.5. X minus 9.5. So these are the ways of obtaining the moment at any section of the beam. It completely depends on you which one to follow, whether to follow the hogging or sagging approach or to follow the method of sections. Up to you, right? So this is one way of perceiving things. This is here AC. This is after AC we have got CD, and this is okay. Once you go beyond D, for all the values of x greater than 9.5, if you go beyond D, then all the three terms. Remember, first term, for all the values of x between 0 and 3, only the first term. For all the values of x between 3 and 9.5, the first two terms are to be considered. For all the values of x greater than 9.5, if you go beyond D, then all the three terms have to be considered. And this is exactly what I've explained in the first video of my Cauley's approach. If you haven't seen that, to watch it. Chalo, ye sara calculation to hua. Ab yahan se aage badhte hain. Let's move ahead. Okay. Now. We need to integrate. You know, we've already seen the deflection formula. EI d2y by dx square is equal to mx at any cross section of the beam. So what we can replace this is this. EI y double dash. Right? Now you need to integrate this. Listen to me very carefully. You need to integrate this equation to get the slope equation. When you do that, let me just show that to you. This is going to become, let's do this in black. E I y double dash will become y dash is equal to 90 x square by 2. Again, the first constant is introduced with the first term, right? This is still the first term. And let me have a separation line. AC minus 90 times of x minus 3 whole square divided by 2. Again, a separation line from C to D minus 60 times of x minus 9.5 square whole divided by 2. Okay, now let's integrate this again. And later on, once we have both slope and deflection forms, we are going to ultimately put up the boundary conditions, rather apply the boundary conditions to find the value of C1 and C2. Dekhte hain usko bhi. So now integrating this again, what are we going to have? EIY is equal to 90 times x cube over 6. C1 will become C1x plus a new constant of integration C2. Again, this is the first separation line, minus 90 times of x minus 3 cube divided by 6. Again, a separation line from C to D, minus 60 times of x minus 9.5 cube whole divided by 6. So these are essentially the two equations. These are rather raw equations because we are yet to calculate the values of C1 and C2. Ab ye kaise calculate honge? Well, the only way forward is to apply the boundary conditions. Karke dikhate hain aapko bade pyar se, sari cheezon ko samjhenge. What are those boundary conditions? First of all, let me tell you. Now guys, if you watch carefully, at this very point, the deflection is going to be zero. That means this qualifies as our first boundary condition, which states that at x is equal to zero, deflection at A is equal to 0. Simple. Secondly, at x is equal to 14, at this endpoint, again the deflection is going to be 0. So on applying these two boundary conditions, we can calculate the values of C1 and C2. Let's go ahead. Why wait? Chalo, aage badhte hain. Pehla deflection. Chalo, pehla equation lagate hain. What? At x is equal to 0. What is 0? Deflection is 0. So guys, this over here is the deflection equation. X is equal to 0. 0. So by the way, first of all, which terms are to be considered and which terms not to consider? Just take a look. If you compress this, you'll have x is equal to 0. You're right here. That is at ND. If x is equal to 0, you're obviously working between section. You're working in section AC. Right? In the portion AC of the beam. So for AC portion of the beam, only the first term has to be considered. If you're going to consider only the first term, right, that means before this separation line, what you have is brilliant. What you have is this much. This much of the equation has to be applied for this condition. When you do that, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. That means automatically the value of C2 is going to work out as 0. Now we know the value of C2 is 0. But how to get the value of C1? Well, you need to apply another boundary condition. Kaise karenge? To uska calculation main side mein kar dunga. just take a look at this. Again, at x is equal to 14, y is equal to 0. But how are you going to do this? X is equal to 14. The entire span of the beam now will be considered. That means you are beyond this point T, or you are right at point B. Then in that case, all the terms will be considered. All of this will be considered. Right? And previously you saw x was how much? X was 0. So going by a different logic, you just plug in the value 0, 0, 0. If you put the value 0 over here, just take a look what's inside the bracket. What's inside? 0 minus 3 is minus 3. Regardless of what power it is, you just need to check what's inside. If it's a negative value, discard. 0. 0 minus 9.5, that is 9.5. It's a negative value, discard. But when you put the value of x is equal to 14, what you have? 14, 14, 14, not an issue. Well, this is 0. 14, 14, 14 minus 3. Well, it's a positive value. That is how much? 14 mein se 3 gaya to bacha 11. Aur yahan se bhi 14 mein se 9.5 gaya. To kuch to bachega, 4.5 bachega. Positive values aa rahe hain, matlab in sab ko accept karna hai. Right? So this is one more trick which you can apply to ascertain, to work out which terms to consider and what not to. Aage bade. Ab ye calculate karna hai yaar. That is our priority. How to calculate the value of C1. That is going to be very important for us. So a bit of calculation needs to be worked out. Wo calculation main kahan karu? Ye soch raha hu yaar main. To yaar calculation ke liye na choti si jagah bana lete hain. Just take a look at this. EIY, LHS, we've got 0. Then we've got 90x cube by 6. So this calculation is going to be 19 to x cube. That is 14 ka cube divided by 6. Brilliant. Plus C1 into x. That means plus 14 times of C1. थोड़ा अच्छे से लिखते हैं. अलग अलग टर्म्स है. प्लस 14 टाइम्स ऑफ C1. C2, यू नो व्हाट C2 इज? C2 इज हाउ मच? C2 इज 0. सो लिखो ना लिखो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता है. माइनस, अगेन माइनस साइन, व्हाट? 90 इनटू 14 माइनस 3 इज 11. यू गॉट 11 क्यूब ओवर 6. डन. एंड फाइनली यार इसको ब्रैकेट के अंदर लिखते हैं. एंड फाइनली यहाँ पे फिर से एक माइनस का चिन्ह है. 60 इंटू ये कितना आ जाएगा? 14 माइनस 9.5, 9.5 से 10, आधा में 4 और जोड़ दो, 4.5. ठीक है, तो ये हो जाएगा 60 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय कितना बोला मैंने? 4.5 क्यूब डिवाइडेड बाय 6. एंड दिस इज व्हाट यू नीड टू कैलकुलेट. इस इक्वेशन को अगर आप सॉल्व करेंगे ना, वंस यू सॉल्व दिस इक्वेशन, यू आर गोइंग टू इवेंचुअली गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ सी टू, नॉट सी टू बट सी वन. और कहाँ सॉल्व करते बैठूंगा मैं आपको सीधा वैल्यू बता रहा हूँ. सी वन का वैल्यू कितना आएगा? दिस इज गोइंग टू वर्क आउट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी चेक. 19 into 14, ठीक है. 19 14, ठीक है. माइनस माइनस या ब्रिलियंट ब्रिलियंट. 14 माइनस 3 11. ओके, एंड दैट्स गोना बी 4.5. यस, गोइंग इन द राइट डायरेक्शन. सी वन विल वर्क आउट एज 14.48 माइनस के चिन्ह के साथ, अलॉन्ग विद अ नेगेटिव साइन. आई मीन देयर आर, दिस इज सो मच मैथमेटिक्स इन्वॉल्व. अगर एक भी जगह माइनस का प्लस हो गया तो पूरा गड़बड़ हो गया. ठीक है, सो आई गॉट टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल. सो दैट्स ओवर. नाउ यू हैव गॉट योर स्लोप इक्वेशन. आई लेट यू नो व्हाट द स्लोप इक्वेशन फाइनली इज. आपको यहाँ पे दिखाता हूँ द स्लोप एंड डिफ्लेक्शन इक्वेशन फाइनली कहाँ पे लिखे. लेट्स मेक सम स्पेस ओवर हियर. Let's write the slope and deflection equation. Okay. So first of all, let's write the slope equation. Slope equation. Likhe? Okay. Here we go. EIY dash. Okay, one more thing which you need to be worried about. Just take a look at this. Just think about this. What is this 90? It's that point load. Okay, or this load, you can also say this 90 90 60. These are all point loads and they have been taken in kilonewton. So you need to do the conversion at some point or the other. You need to do the conversion. So yahan pe bhi 10 to the power 3 for kilos, here 10 to the power 3, here 10 to the power 3, here, everywhere. If you take a look, EIY dash is going to be equal to 10 to the power, I mean the stuff inside the bracket multiplied by 10 to the power 3, isn't it? This is inside the bracket, and in each and every term you'll have a 10 to the power 3 for kilo, right? here also, here also. So you can take 10 to the power 3 common and you can write this stuff like this. So what you can essentially do is EIY dash whole divided by 10 to the power 3 is equal to the stuff inside the bracket. That means this stuff, and that's it. This is one way of writing the slope equation. And I would suggest all of you to write the slope equation in this form only. If this had been in Newton's, no issues. You could have gone ahead, right, and simply solved. But since this is in kilonewton, so some kind of modification in the slope as well as deflection equation has to be worked out. Or wo ye. ठीक है, मेरे ख्याल में समझ में आ गया होगा. इस पूरे में से हर एक टर्म में से हम लोगों ने 10 टू द पावर 3 कॉमन ले लिया. क्यों? क्योंकि न्यूटन नहीं है, वो किलो न्यूटन है, और उसको फिर यहां नीचे ले आया है. वंस यू डू दिस, ओके, सो लेट मी जस्ट फाइनली राइट द स्लोप इक्वेशन एंड हियर वी गो. ई आई, व्हाट? ई आई वाई डैश होल डिवाइडेड बाय 10 टू द पावर 3 इज इक्वल टू, ओके, कहां गया स्लोप? ये 90 बाई 2 इज 45, 45 एक्स स्क्वायर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस इज गोना बी 45 एक्स स्क्वायर, ओके, व्हाट एल्स? प्लस c1, सो वी हैव गॉट द वैल्यू ऑफ c1, माइनस 14.48 4, ठीक है, इसमें से भी 10 टू द पावर 3 बाहर निकल चुका है, राइट. सेकेंडली 90 बाई 2 अगेन 45, माइनस 45 एक्स माइनस 3 स्क्वायर,
माइनस 45 एक्स माइनस 3 होल स्क्वायर.
एंड किधर गया, किधर गया? वी हैव गॉट टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. 60 बाई 2 इज 30, सो 30
माइनस 30 टाइम्स ऑफ एक्स माइनस व्हाट? 9.5 स्क्वायर.
सो दैट्स द फाइनल इक्वेशन ऑफ स्लोप. एंड लेट मी जस्ट वेरी क्विकली मेक अ चेक. 45 एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 14.48 4 माइनस 45 एक्स माइनस 3 का पावर 2 और 30 एक्स माइनस 9.5 का पावर 2, डन. अब यार यहाँ पे सेपरेशन लाइन बना देते हैं. लेट मी मेक दी सेपरेशन लाइन्स, रादर मार्क देम. ए सी सी एंड डी, एंड वंस यू गो बियॉन्ड डी, वंस यू हैव द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स मोर देन 9.5, देन यू हैव टू कंसिडर ऑल द टर्म्स, राइट. If the value of x is between 0 and 3, first term only. If the value of x is between, let's say, between more than 3 and less than 9.5, then you have to consider the two terms. And if it is more than 9.5, you know, all the terms have to be considered. Anyway, this was the slope equation, how to make the deflection equation. Ab ye dekhte hain. Deflection equation. Let me just write this deflection equation in the same manner as I have written the slope equation. It is going to be same. और यहाँ पे भी आप मान के चलिए आपने क्या किया है, इन सब में से 10 टू द पावर 3 कॉमन निकाल लिया और उसको नीचे शिफ्ट कर दिया है. तो अल्टीमेटली ये कैसे लिखाएगा? लेट मी जस्ट टेल यू, दिस इज गोइंग टू बी ई आई वाई ओवर 10 टू द पावर 3, एंड थोड़ा सा मैथमेटिक्स लगेगा. 15 छक्के 90, तो 15 एक्स की पावर 3, 15 एक्स टू द पावर 3, 15 एक्स टू द पावर 3, डन. व्हाट एल्स? C1x, C1 कितना है? माइनस 1448.84,
माइनस 1448.84 टाइम्स ऑफ x.
अब यहां पे आ गया, दिस इज गोना बी आवर फर्स्ट सेपरेशन लाइन, फर्स्ट सेपरेशन लाइन, दैट्स AC, डन. व्हाट्स नेक्स्ट? C2 0, ओके, डोंट वरी. 90 बटे 6 फिर से 15 आ जाएगा और यहां पे 10 आ जाएगा, ठीक है. माइनस 10 x माइनस 3 होल क्यूब,
माइनस 10 x माइनस 3 होल क्यूब.
सेपरेशन लाइन कहाँ के लिए? C और D के बीच वाले सेक्शन के लिए, मतलब दोनों टर्म्स ले लोगे आप. एंड फाइनली यू गॉट दिस, 60 बाई 6 इज 10, 10 टाइम्स ऑफ x माइनस 9.5,
माइनस 10 टाइम्स ऑफ x माइनस 9.5, एंड दिस इज अगेन क्यूब.
फिर से चेक कर लें, क्योंकि एक भी मिस्टेक तो गए भैया. फिर 15 x की पात 3 माइनस 14, ठीक है, ठीक है, 10 आ गया क्या वहां पे? एक चीज चेक करना पड़ेगा, 6 को 15 से गुणा करेंगे ना, तो यहां पे 10 लिख दिया भैया मैंने गलती से, क्षमा करें, सुधार लेते हैं, ठीक है. 15 एक्स माइनस 3 का क्यूब और 10 एक्स माइनस 9.5 का क्यूब, राइट. सो दिस इज एसेंशियली व्हाट वी वर लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू. सो वंस यू हैव द स्लोप एंड डिफ्लेक्शन इक्वेशन, द स्टेप्स टू फॉलो is pretty simple. Just put the value and get the answer. Plug in the value and get the answer, as I always say this. Okay, so the first thing to do is this. Deflection under point loads. How to do this? Thoda mitate hain yaar yahan pe. Deflection under point loads. Kaise karna hai? Just keep on watching. This is going to be brilliant. Okay? And I'll also provide you the notes, the complete solution of this particular problem in a PDF file format. You can access it from the description. Sab mil jayega aapko. But you need to understand the process. Anyway, to kare, chalu kare karyakram, right? So this is over now. So working out the slope and deflection equations, that's over. First thing that we need to work with, deflection. कहाँ पर डिफ्लेक्शन निकालना है? हमें निकालना है डिफ्लेक्शन अंडर द पॉइंट लोड्स. तो पहला केस देखिए, डिफ्लेक्शन अंडर 60 किलोन्यूटन लोड. 60 है, व्हाट डू वी हैव ओवर हियर? ओके, दैट्स 90 किलोन्यूटन्स. डिफ्लेक्शन अंडर 90 किलोन्यूटन लोड कहाँ पे? दैट इज एट सी. बोले तो एक्स बराबर कितना रखेंगे यहां से? ये यहां पे आएगा. तो x का वैल्यू, द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज गोइंग टू बी टेकन एज 3 मीटर्स. वंस यू प्लग दिस वैल्यू, प्लग इट इन टू दिस इक्वेशन, यू आर गोइंग टू इमीडिएटली गेट द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस yc. करके दिखाता हूं मैं आपको. वन मोर थिंग आई फॉरगॉट टू टेल यू, व्हाट अबाउट दिस i एंड i, e एंड i, यू कैन सी दैट देयर इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ e एंड i. लेट मी जस्ट शो दैट. e मल्टीप्लाइड बाय i, दैट इज 210 गीगापास्कल. यू कैन वेरीफाई. गीगा मींस 10 टू द पावर 9. I is how much? 64 into 10 raised to minus 4. 64 into 10 raised to minus 4. Once you do the math, just plug this value into a calculator. And let me just make a check. Yeah, aata kitna yaar nikal ke? This is going to work out as 1344 into 10 raised to 6. Oh my God. 1344 into 10 raised to 6. And obviously, this is in Newton per meter square. Right? Giga Pascal. So, giga has been converted. Multiplied by, this is meter power 4. Okay, so the unit is going to be obviously Newton meter square. 1344 into 10 raised to 6. I need to write this somewhere. EI is equal to 1344 into 10 raised to 6. And obviously the units are Newton meter square. Sorry, the handwriting is a bit small. But we all can manage, I guess. Chalo, yahan se. How to move forward? And let me see if the recording is still on or not. Still going on. Anyway, to ye to ho gaya. Isko matate hain. You know, the problems are quite lengthy and it involves a lot of mathematics. So make sure whenever you are solving these problems, you have got to be highly focused. Kuch bhi mistake ho sakta hai, aur mere se to bahut zyada mistake hote hain. I don't know whether you guys have observed this or not, but speaking in front of a camera has its own advantages and disadvantages, because there is nobody to correct you. Koi hai nahi. Agar kuch mistake bhi hota hai, toh there is nobody to correct. That is a huge problem. Teaching in a classroom in front of students, 50 to 60 students, is a different feeling altogether. Even if you go wrong, there is somebody to correct you, provided they should be paying attention. Okay. तो यहां पर डिफ्लेक्शन निकालते हैं. बिंदास डिफ्लेक्शन इक्वेशन लगाओ. ई आई वाई, ई आई का प्रोडक्ट कितना है? 1344 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6. तो यहां पे लिखता हूं मैं आपको, देखो वैल्यूज प्लग इन करके दिखाता हूं. यहां पे 1344 इंटू 10 रेस टू 6 एंड यहां पे नीचे क्या है? 10 रेस टू 3 एंड दिस इज गोना बी वाई एट पॉइंट सी. एट पॉइंट सी ब्रिलियंट इज इक्वल टू 15x³. सो एक्स एक्स हैज टू बी टेकन एज 3, दैट इज एक्स इक्वल टू 3. So this is going to be 15 into 3 cube. Done. Minus 1448.84 into x. 1448.84 into x, that is 3. Okay? So that's it. Some of you guys might be thinking, yaar aage value kyun nahi put kiya? Aage put karne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. Okay? The trick, let me tell you again, the trick. If you put the value of 3 over here, what you have is 3 minus 3 is 0. Khatam. Finished. If you put the value of x is equal to 3 over here, 3 minus 9.5 is 6.5, but with a negative sign. As I have told you, if on plugging in the values, you get a negative sign inside the bracket. Okay, forget about the power. Inside the bracket, if you get a negative sign, that is 3 minus 9.5 will return minus 6.5. Discard that. And this is quite clear. If the value of x is equal to 3, that means we are in the portion AC. If we are in the portion AC, if we are in the portion AC, only this much portion before the separation line, before the separation line, before the separation line, before the separation and before the separation line, the only this much portion has to be considered. That is the entire idea. You just need to guys solve this equation and let me check if everything is moving in the right direction or not. 15 into 3 ka cube karna tha, minus 14, 48.84 into 3 karna tha. Aur idhar 1344 guna 10 ki ghat 6 bate 3 ki ghat 3. And now from here, you are going to get the value of yc. Likh ke batate hain aapko yc kitna aa raha hai. Let me just show that to you. Yc, guys, is going to work out as, kidhar likhe? Kidhar likhe? Kidhar likhe? Yc will be equal to, here, pehli baat to, ye answer minus mein aega, because the deflection is going to happen in the downward, since downward corresponds to negative sign. Yc, well, this is going to be equal to 2.932
into 10 raised to minus 3 meters, and you can also write this as, but with the negative sign. 2.932 in place of 10 to the power minus 3, you can write milli and just write this meter. And where? In the downward sense. What side? Downwards. So that's gonna be your first answer. Thoda zyada samman dete hain yaar isko. Let me just put it up this way. Okay, so that's done. Second, we also need to work out the deflection at a point D. So, yahan pe bhi ek negative value nikal ke aayega, right? Kidhar karein isko? Isko mita de kya? Likhe rehne do. Likhe rehne do. Ek kaam karte hain. Let me make some space. All right, 1a, and this is going to be 1b, right? So what you need to do is, you need to find a deflection under 60 kilonewton load, that is at D. Where is D? It lies at a distance of 9.5 from this origin. That means the value of x has to be plugged in as 9.5 meters. Okay? Everything is going to remain same. You just need to put this value, 9.5, into this deflection equation. Right? And the job is going to be done. Let me show that to you. EI, we all know. 3044 into 10 raised to 6, whole divided by 10 raised to 3. And where are we? We are the at point D. So deflection at point D is going to be equal to, yeah, I got 15 into, ye karo yahan se, 15 multiplied by 9.5 cube, done, minus, this is going to be slightly long, 1448.84 into 9.5 cube, okay, right? And कौन सा पोर्शन कंसिडर करना है, कौन सा नहीं करना है, तो यहां से भी वर्कआउट कर सकते हो आप. इफ यू हियर दिस, दिस टर्म विल बी एक्सेप्टेड, राइट? सो इफ यू वांट टू वर्क आउट हियर, यू वांट टू वर्क आउट हियर, दैट मींस यू आर नॉट गोइंग बियॉन्ड डी. ओके, यू आर राइट हियर. सो ऑब्वियसली इफ यू हैव टू टेक दिस ऑल्सो इंटू कंसिडरेशन, यू आर नॉट गोइंग बियॉन्ड डी, दिस इज बिफोर सी. सो बिफोर सी यू हैव दीज टू टर्म्स. ओके, सो दैट्स इट. माइनस 15 multiplied by, what is the value of x? 9.5. 9.5 minus 3 is 6.5. 6.5 and it's cube. 6.5 and it's cube. Even if you put the value 9.5 over here, this is going to get 0. So don't worry. If it becomes 0, not an issue. If it becomes negative, then also discard it. Okay, immediately remove it. And yes, this is the equation which you need to solve. And let me just very quickly make a check. 1344 left ka to sahi hai, 15 into 9.5 cube, theek hai, minus ka chinnam, 1448 into 9.5 cube, yes,
And then what we have over here is 15 into 6.5 cube. And obviously, guys, when you solve this, you are going to get the value of deflection at this very point. Deflection at point D. And this is in negative. Let me just check how much this value work out as. -3.737.
3.737 × 10⁻³ meters. And this can also be written as simply 3.737 millimeters. You can also say, instead of putting the negative sign, you can just say this is in the downward direction. And that's it.
So, thoda samman de dete hain isko.
Let's enclose this in a bracket.
The problems are not so time taking when you solve it. Let me tell you, because when I solve, I need to explain each and every step, right? I'm a teacher. Therefore, I need to explain each and every step. I need to lay emphasis on each and every concept. But with practice, obviously, the time is going to reduce. Okay, so that's, these two things are done.
So that's over for you. That's over. What you need now is this maximum deflection. How to work it out?
Okay. Just take a look at this illustration. This is going to be brilliant. And you've got a beam like this, and you've got a simply support over here at the ends, and then you've got 2-point loads.
So obviously, the bend is, beam is going to bend in this fashion. The maximum bend will be somewhere in this region, isn't it? Somewhere in this region between these 2-point loads. So between C and D, you can say that the maximum deflection will happen. Wherever we have the maximum deflection, if you make a tangent over there, the slope is going to be zero. So slope for what? Slope for region C and D is equal to zero. This is exactly what you need to do. For maximum deflection, you need to put the slope equation equal to zero. And the maximum deflection might happen between portion C and D. And for C and D, we need to consider only this much portion. We don't have to go beyond D. So you have to discard this term. Only this much portion shall be equal to zero.
To karte hain isko, theek hai?
That's it. That was the explanation.
Maximum deflection.
Sure. Second part of the problem. Maximum deflection. As I've told you, it lies where slope is zero. So we already know it is between where? C and D. So you just need to equate slope CD is equal to zero. You need to do this. So where is it? You've got the slope equation. Only this much portion equated to zero, and that's it. You are going to get a certain value of x. For that value of x, the deflection is going to be maximum. Put that value of x over here to get the maximum deflection. कैसे करना है मैं करके दिखाता हूँ. फिर से मैं बता देता हूँ आपको. सिर्फ इतने टर्म को इक्वल टू जीरो रखना है. Only this much term has to be equated to zero. Let me just show how that can be done. So it's 45 x square. Done. Minus 1448.84. Anything else? Minus 45 times of x minus 3 whole square, and that's equal to 0. On solving this equation, you are going to get a certain value of x, and that is also very important. You know, x
kitna aega? Let me check the equation first. 45 x power 2, 40 ke fir ye hai 45 x minus 3. Done. X is going to work out as 6.866.
6.866 meters. That's brilliant.
Okay. This is an important result, because based on this, we can calculate the maximum deflection. Karke dikhate hain aapko wo kaisa aayega. Let's see.
Maximum deflection. So for this value, what's x? X is 6.866. If you watch, that's 3. And here, when we reach here, that's 9. So this value lies between x is equal to 3 and x is equal to 9.5. Right? So we are in the portion CD. If we are in the portion CD, that means only this much has to be considered. Okay? Once again, value of x is equal to 8.66. So 6.866. 6.866 is between x is equal to 3. Here we have x is equal to 3. And once you reach here, with respect to this, once you reach here, that's x is equal to 9.5.
So 6.866 is in between C and point D. That means for C and D, you need to consider only these terms. And then rest is going to follow. Okay. So here we go. Just take a look at this equation. EI y over 10 raised to 3. What's EY? EI is nothing but 1344 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 10 raised to 3 dot y max. Let me just try this. Y max, okay, is equal to 15x cube. What is x? 6.866. 15 into 6.866 cube. Done. Minus 1448.84 into 6.866. Done. Finally, you have to take this term. Even if you put the value of 6.8 over here, 6.8 minus 9.5, this is going to return a negative value. If it's a negative value, you know very well, it has to be discarded. Okay. Finally, यहाँ पे क्या आएगा? Minus 15 आएगा और आएगा x, x बोले तो 6.866 minus 3 and it's cube. Simple सा math है. चाहता तो मैं 3.866 भी लिख सकता था and to the power 3. That could have been done very easily. And finally, you're going to get the value of maximum deflection. कितना है maximum value? Let me just tell that. मैंने तो already calculate करके रखा है. Minus 4.434 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. You just do the conversion. इसको plus में ही लिखो अभी आप. 4.434 10 to the power minus 3 को बनाओ मिली. ये है meter. और यहाँ पर नीचे लिख लो आप downwards. Obviously, all the loads are acting in the downward direction. Therefore, the deflection is going to be this. Downwards. Okay. That's it. That is the entire solution. Maximum deflection, done. So guys, in the next problem, we are going to come across a simply supported beam but with a uniformly distributed load. That is going to be awesome. Okay, so do watch it. So that was all for today. I'm going to see you again in the next video. Until then, take care. Have a nice day. Keep learning, keep watching, and thank you.